Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So we are back again with the discussion of day 29, 5 MCQs a day. Now this is a regular series brought to you by EduTap, where each day we discuss 5 different MCQs. Now these MCQs are relevant for NABARD Grade A and B 2018 examination. They also find relevance for those examinations that have agriculture as its core component, like IBPS AFO, FCI, IBPS AFO Scale 2 in RRB 2018 examinations. So yes, the NABARD Grade A admit cards are out, so kindly download those. The prelims is going to be held on 19th May 2018 and the mains shall be held on 6th June 2018. Now friends, before we proceed today, there's an important announcement. So EduTap has brought out NABARD Grade A Current Affairs Punch Course. It covers the current affairs related to Phase 1 and Phase 2. So today is the last day to avail the discount on this course. The original price or the MRP of this course is ₹4,500. Currently, we are running a 33% off. So you will be getting this course for ₹3,000. There is no need to apply any coupon code. You can directly go and buy this course from our portal. So today till midnight, you can get this course for ₹3,000. After that, the price will be back to its MRP. Now friends, what does this course offer? Basically, we all know that current affairs play a very, very important role in NABARD Grade A examination. So basically, as part of this course, we shall cover the following that you can see on your screens. Like, we offer more than 2000 GA MCQs, which are based on current affairs from the month of Jan 2018. There are 500 plus static GK MCQs. And we also provide a monthly magazine, which is ESI in News and ARD in News. Along with that, we also provide topic wise current affairs video for ESI as well as for ARD. We also give you PIB summary videos and MCQs for ESI as well as for agriculture. We also have the economic survey 2017-18 videos with MCQs, and then we also have the budget 2018-19 videos and MCQs with detailed explanations. Now we have also covered the following reports, like India State of Forest Report 2015 and 17, the Agriculture Census, the Census 2011, the Socio-Economic and Caste Census. We also provide Yojana Magazine, Kurukshetra Magazine, Important Agriculture Schemes, and we also cover the important reports of various ministries like Ministry of Agriculture, Ministry of Rural Development and Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So friends, this is a very important course, keeping in mind the importance of current affairs in NABARD Grade A examination. Now friends, back to the lecture today. So what are we going to discuss? So this week we have been discussing questions that are taken directly from NABARD's Model Bankable Project Report. Now these questions I had mentioned earlier are very important because in the previous year there were direct questions asked from this report. Now you don't need to go deeper into the concepts because there's nothing much concrete in relation to the concepts when you go through these reports. So you just need to memorize the important data points that we have brought to you through these MCQs. So let us start with the discussion of question number one. So here the question says, what is India's rank in the world in terms of onion production? Now it is a very direct question. The answer is second. Now friends, the country that stands first in the world in terms of onion production is China, and after that India stands second. So if you see, India accounts for nearly 16% of total area which is under onion cultivation, and if you talk in terms of total production, it is 10% of the total. Now let us discuss question number two. So it says, for effective long storage of onion, the optimum storage range of relative humidity is 65% to 70%, with the temperature ranging between how much? Now the answer to this question is 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. This is a straight, there are two data points that you can derive from this question. One is the relative humidity, 65% to 70%, and the next data point is the effective temperature range, that is 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. So here again the same thing is mentioned, so kindly pause the video and once go through this explanation. Next, let us discuss question number 3. So it says DASH is generally defined as information and technology based farm management system to identify, analyze and manage the variability within fields for optimum profitability, sustainability and protection of the land resource. So basically this is a question related to the general definition. Now the answer to this question is precision farming. This is a very important definition, so kindly go through this again and again. So here again the same thing that we have just now had a look at, that what is precision farming. Now friends, basically what do we mean by this is within fields, we are micromanaging the fields. Basically if you take a field, it is generally spread through vast acres of land, right? So what we are doing is within that field, we are selecting small areas and concentrating on those areas, like what would be the effective inputs that are required for those areas, right? But in India, if you see, there is a prevalence of farming where you have fragmented lands. And because of that, you can see the last point that in the Indian context, with its severe land fragmentation, precision farming has to do more with the precise application of agricultural inputs. Okay, so based on what conditions we are deciding the agricultural inputs, based on what is the type of soil, what is the weather requirements there, what is the crop requirement to maximize sustainable productivity, the quality of the crop and the profitability. So kindly pause this video and have a rough idea as to what do we mean by precision farming. Next, coming to question number 4, it says which of the following term is used to denote the loss of normal green color from the foliage on the older, more mature leaves as well as the younger foliage, right? So this is a concept which we have dealt numerous times. There was a lecture that was dedicated specifically towards plant nutrition, and in that lecture we had seen three terms: chlorosis, necrosis, mottling. So again, a kind of revision, and these things were also found in the NABARD's Model Bankable Project Report. Now the answer to this question is chlorosis. Here you can again see the definition of chlorosis in detail. So kindly have a look at it. We would not be discussing this much because we are just concerned with the questions that are coming in the from the Model Bankable Project Reports. Here you can have a look at the definition of necrosis and hypoplasia. Let us see hypoplasia. Basically, they're talking about the failure of plants or the plant organs to develop fully. And this happens due to the decreased production of the number of cells. So basically, for any organism or any organ to develop fully, the cells need to multiply and develop properly, right? So when there is a decreased production of the number of cells, there is a failure of organs. That is very natural. So that we term as it as hypoplasia. And friends, whenever you come across this term hypo, it usually means less. And the opposite word for hypo is hyper, which usually means more. So you can actually keep a clue like this whenever you come across something starting with hypo. Now, hypoplasia results in plants or plant parts of subnormal size. Obviously, if there is a failure of plant organs and it is not fully developed, so the size of the plants or the plant subparts also would not be developed to the full extent. Now let us have a look at question number 5. So it says generally the entire plant becomes lighter green, but the effect will be most noticeable on the older foliage. Gradually the oldest leaves lose their green color and most plants become yellow. The flowers are smaller and may lack well developed color. So which nutrient deficiency is being referred to here? Now the answer to this question is nitrogen. Now friends, you might be wondering that why are we discussing these questions, like, you know, this kind of a question was already discussed when we were having a look at the plant nutrition lecture. But what happens is usually the same wording of the question will not be found in the paper. So you need to basically understand the concept, like for in this case, we are dealing with the concept of the deficiencies of various mineral nutrients, right? So now you know that because of nitrogen, what are the visual symptoms that are seen in the plant? But you need to revise revise it again and again and make sure that however the questions are being phrased, you need to hit at the right answer. Now, many of you might have understood the visual symptoms of nitrogen, but after seeing this question, you would not be able to answer the tick the correct answer. The reason being, you have very superficially gone through the deficiency symptoms. You need to be very clear in your head, like what is the nutrient, and when there's a deficiency of that particular nutrient, what are the symptoms? If you're not satisfied with the provided material, you can also go out and Google for your satisfaction so that you are thorough with the answer. Here again, they have just given the explanation that we have dealt right now in the questions, that what happens when there is a nitrogen deficiency. Now here you can have a look at the various answers for the questions that we had discussed today. So friends, with this we have come to the end of the lecture today. So again, we had an elaborate discussion regarding the 5 MCQs that were taken from the NABARD's model bankable project reports. By now you should have been thorough with all the questions that we had discussed taken from these reports. These are very important, so revise them once you go before the examination. Now if you really found this video useful, kindly like, subscribe and share. The PDF format of this particular video can be accessed from EduTap's Telegram channel, and the link for the channel is placed on your screens. And thank you so much for the response that you have given for this series. It really gives us the motivation to work harder. Till then, friends, thank you so much and happy learning.